if I've ever seen such a blatant conspiracy on my hands. You know, the very fabric of our country, I would say, is at risk. The danger afoot? Who's behind it? It's hard to say. I always say, follow the money. And thanks for that. But, you know, I'm just saying. Thanks for that follow. That really means a lot to everybody involved. What am I talking about? The pool industry, of course. You know, who's behind Big Pool? Who stands to make money from building pools? Jesus fucking Christ. And I'd be lucky if it raises the value of the house, you know, 20 grand. Just for a tiny fucking pool. But you know what it costs? Don't ever grow up, kids. Stay dumb and young. Keep renting from old white men, you fucking noobs. I've been watching a lot of Muslim YouTube. Guys, welcome to the show. Nobody likes onions. Bravo on you for making it. If you joined us earlier for our exclusive coverage of the Apple, of the Tim Allen Apple conference. Of the new MacBooks and Mac bikes, you'll know that I've been on one today. Just really sipping from that lettuce, as the kids
smoke weed every day
say. And I have no shame for it. I don't really care your opinions on it either. We're going to be joined shortly by Roy S. Johnson, Esquire. Which will be nice to have him on. Haven't had a guest on in a while. Don't really care to either, you know. But he seems to have something to say. It'll be nice to hear somebody else rant and maybe a different point of view for one. I would love to actually argue with someone besides the chat room. What say you? I went to Costco the other day to get my eyes examined. I've been told by several people in my life, this is the place to go to get your glasses done. Costco eye exams. Good prices, great frames. You're going to love the way you blink. I was told to go there to get it. Hold on. Waterco Group, Swimline, Florida. hold on. Fluid Rasa. Fluidra, Pool Corp, Inc. These are big pool corps. Big pool. I'll get to them in a minute. Keep that information handy for a cut and paste when I want to circle back. I'm going off on Costco and their vision department right now. And why nobody talks about the fucking privilege I don't get all the time for being a giant male. Is it my fault I'm white and 6'5"? And maybe look like I've had one too many meatball subs. Today. Like, come on. Like, fuck off. Will you understand how many times I've gotten just looked over at a bar? You know? I don't want to fucking hear it. I don't want to hear it anymore now. I go into Costco. I go in there. I pay full price for the eye exam. I've heard it's great. Great. I write down. I'm filling out their form. They're like, we don't take insurance. You have to pay cash. Fine. It's $125 for a prescription. I had to get a new prescription. The contacts I had before, they would dry out so much here in Vegas. I don't know if people know this. Like, it gets really, really dry here in Vegas. And I like to leave them in for days, even though you're not supposed to. The ones I had, they were shit. Biomedic or something. I don't know what they were. They were garbage. I hated them. Before I had the ones you could like use every 2 weeks. AccuView Oasis. I liked those. I'm going to go back to those, I think. I might switch. Who's behind AccuView Oasis? Johnson & Johnson or Bausch & Lomb's? Bausch & Lowe's. Big Lumber. Don't get me started. Don't get me started on Big Lumber and Tool. And die. Everybody who tools dies. Everybody who's got to die. Obviously tools around from time to time. So listen, I use AccuView. Great lenses. AccuView Oasis are the best. Okay. Some great, great fans of AccuView Oasis. AccuView Oasis. God, I got too high on that. What is it again? Bohemian Brothers Star Pie. If you're going to try some wheat, I recommend Bohemian Brothers Star Pie. Keep your head up and keep your high higher. Bohemian Brothers. I don't know if there's a way to get that label where it's visible. Either way, dive in. They're the only ones with the cool designed pouch where you can also see the weed on the bottom, okay? Okay. Don't forget to get it. Bohemian Brothers. I'm dealing with Big Elevator. That's another story. Pardon me for the weed. But I'll tell you this. I go in there. The exam's great. I get the thing where I have to write my occupation down. Now, I will say this. I'm becoming more and more inclined to be grossed out at calling myself a comedian. I am watching my comedian friends posting on Facebook about returning to comedy. You know, and I'm finding it very, very cringe. These are guys who are like doing sets at a fucking bar, you know? Some of them have been excited about it the whole time. What's Chunkle's Cantina? You know? Imagine being excited about that in your life. Most of these shows don't pay. And if they do, it's $10, $25. And for you to be posting about being jazzed to do it is, woo, bad news, bad times. Don't get me involved. I am buying a fortress and I am building a pool from Big Pool. Big Pool and Die. But these aren't even like pool company. You know what I mean? Because like I'm having a pool built like out of concrete. There's so much. The other day it got so expensive, you know, or approaching 60,000. But you know, tomorrow's my birthday. So why not live a little, build a pool? I'll be dead soon. Who cares if it's financed? Money. No, I'll probably end up putting $30,000 into all this shit, like cash. And then finance the remainder. Big birthday is behind it. I'm more interested in big water and big chlorine. Yeah, that's why we're getting out of it. We're going big salt. The clean at 12:15. But yeah, cheers. It is my birthday. Thank you to people. There's somebody named Wesley sent in a Amazon card. I'm telling everybody, give me Amazon cards. You know how it is when you move. You just need tons of shit. I will be building out a brand new studio there. You know, we're going to do some really innovative stuff. I heard about this stuff you can get for the floor that makes it seem like you're on a beach all the time. Like nobody's doing that. Nobody, sand. That's what it is. No one's doing that shit. Is there anybody else have a sandcastle studio? Fuck no, but with your help, we'll do it. I'll get a guy in here who can like spray wand, or we'll get some like get some of that Gorilla Glue adhesive in a can. We spray that on the wall. We just keep throwing sand. We just throw sand at the wall. Just keep hitting it. Just keep dipping it. Just keep flipping it. It's gonna be fucking awesome. I heard there's cheap sand in Nevada. Yeah, I know a guy. I got a great sand guy. Find another podcast who's got like sand men. Salmon. Mr. Salmon, bring me some sand. Yeah, no, it'll be great. But yeah, if you want to do anything for my birthday, honestly, suck my dick and give me Amazon gift cards. Get back to the Kirkland eye exam. Thank you very much for keeping me on track. You know, a lot of people don't speak up when I go off for fear that I'll just yell and snap at them. But actually, I like it when somebody keeps me on track, especially when it's clear that I've been smoking too much weed. Is the pool going to be RGB and RTX compatible? Who are these people who are getting pool lights installed and not getting the color ones? They're all LED now anyway, I'm pretty sure. And I think, like, I'm getting three. I'm getting one up on my sun deck, and I'm getting two down in the pool, facing different directions, so they'll light up the two walls. I got a whole design 3D model done. It's great. You won't believe it. My neighbor just went RGB and even put in a cooler. You can get a cooler? All right. You're going to need to send a lot of Amazon gift cards for this stuff. I want to hear about this Mexican eye doctor. Pool was getting way too hot. This show's getting too hot. It's getting too hot for pool talk. That's real stuff. Yeah, so I go in there, I write down, I get real uncomfortable with writing down comedian, because who knows if you'll ever do it again. And I write down entertainer, which, you know, saying it out loud and to you now is far more douchey. I will be the first one to fucking admit that. I made a horrible, horrible error. There on that front. So yeah, I go in there, I get the eye exam, I come out, and this girl at the front desk has found my YouTube and is like, oh, we're watching your clip. It's like, what is going on? You know, and by the way, you know, what about HIPAA regulations? It's where you're not allowed to look up the medical information of fat patients. HIPAA regulations. So I don't know what's going on there. But I come out with my prescription. I want to get glasses. I want to get contact lenses. You know, normally I would just order them online. But I figure I'm there. I'm in the store. They've got Kirkland contact lenses. They're super cheap. Plus, I want to try these ones she gave me. These are the ones I'm wearing now, Precision One, which are very nice. These are very shiny. They come in a box. But I don't like that either. I don't like when they spend too much money on the gold, on the silver foil, on the box. It lets me know that you've got too big of a budget. And on two sides, a little too flashy, a little too ostentatious. Glasses and contacts, someone has money. Are those good for folks with astigmatism? I don't have astigmatism. But no, I wouldn't think so. I think they need... What is astigmatism? I thought if you had astigmatism, you can't have contact lenses. But what do I know? Clearly, I've been proven nothing but wrong. As has Wes. So drink up, everybody. It's like $170 for contact and eyeglass script. Hold on, astigmatism is weird shaped eyes? Oh my God. Is that a tell? Do I have weird shaped eyes? What are you saying? This feels like a personal attack. Which one is weirder shaped? Okay, this is the right. This is the left. Which one is weirder shaped? Football shaped. Get out of here. That's called an eye slit, an eye opening. you know, behind the ball, if you dig the ball out, if anybody has a shoehorn, you could jam in behind it and flop it out. You'd fucking see. You don't know me. Look it up. No way. No way. That's like when you look up, when you Google meth teeth, American football. Yep. We're going to talk election. We are, of course, going to talk election. We're, of course, going to talk all that stuff. We're going to have Roy Johnson on soon whenever he calls. I don't know if he's going to text me or something when he's ready. But we'll be talking to him. He says he has rants locked and loaded, ready to scream. I can't wait. So when he wants to call, I don't know if he's watching. I should text him and let him know. But I'll finish the Costco story. So I go over there. Basically, I want to buy contacts. Skype. Oh, if he, I don't know. Yeah, who knows if Roy knows how to use this stuff? Last time I saw him, he was at Best Buy buying a Dell laptop. Can you imagine the configuration of laptop Dell threw together for Best Buy to make enough margin on that fucking product? Like, the whole point of buying from Dell is like, all right, well, Dell makes a little more profit and you get the laptop a little cheaper. We're cutting out the middleman. You buy it from Dell. Now, Best Buy comes along because Dell is a brand name computer now. And if you're in Best Buy, you're likely to buy the Dell because you've heard of Dell. You're like, oh, I can get a Dell at Best Buy? Guess what kind of Dell that's going to be? Shit. Will Roy be talking about baseball? You can bet your bottom dollar. Every day he posts how many days until pitchers and catchers report. I bet he won't address the voting fraud. Just watch. Heard at Rick's they're using Trump ballots to wipe the plates off of fire. We'll get him on the big screen. We'll share him with you guys. You're going to love the way Roy talks to you and treats you like people. All right, we've got him messaged. Gateways are back at Walmart? Get the fuck out of here. Okay, well, this is crazy. Anyway, I go to, I got to look up Walmart because I don't even believe that. That sounds nuts. Gateway. The Gateway. Walmart.com. Is this what? Hold on. Is this what you were talking about? The Gateway by Obert Skye. It's a paperback for $10.41. You can get free 2-day delivery. Pickup not available. I saw the cow box. Where? Gateway, Walmart.com, laptops. Here we go. Whoa. This is what I thought. I thought Apple today would announce when they announced the new MacBook Pros and stuff. That they would announce colors and things like that. You know, a new look. Something more modern, you know? Like I said, like Elle Woods would have used in Legally Blonde. You know, when she was toting around that old clamshell. Look at these. These are just the same old. So, yeah, the same way Walmart capitalized on this Gateway shit, that's what Best Buy, I guess, does with Dell. And either way, it's very fucking embarrassing for Roy to go buy a Dell from a big box store. But he did, and it probably doesn't work already. Whoever the weirdos are messaging on Skype, there's some weird stuff like Sabrina. I'd like to add you on Skype. By the way, we're going to get to the bottom of Sabrina's starfish. What's her name? When will Lane Libra ever let us talk about his ex-girlfriend? Lane and Stephanie. But her escort name was like Sabrina Sunfire or something. Nobody can remember what it was. Sabrina Scarface. Break me off a piece of that. Sabrina Saunderson. Does anybody remember what I'm talking about? So Lane, our old buddy Lane, you know, nice man. His ex-girlfriend, who was on several shows, was like, now an escort. And she goes by the name, like, Sabrina Stoitsky. I don't know. And you can look it up. If you Google her, it's like Sabrina Sun. Fucking hell. We used to know this off the top of our head. But anyway, if you Google that name, you can find all of her like sex ads and stuff. And then you try to get Lane to talk about it because he'll be in the chat a lot of the time. Didn't they do incest porn? What? I don't know anything about this. Tell me more. Incest porn. Oh, is that where they like pretend to be brother and sister? There's some cringe stuff y'all be doing sexually. Maybe I don't get it. Maybe I don't. I don't really know. I don't really understand the ways of the. Is this the same Lane that groped you in a hotel? Fuck yes. I forgot about that. I forgot about my sexual assault, which did happen. That is legit. And he is lucky I didn't press charges on that. I think I might be getting corona. I don't know. How do you know? What are the symptoms again? We've been through this so long. By the way, no one gives a fuck, right, about corona now. We've all just moved the fuck on. That's insane. Like, isn't there like 1,100 people dying a day, which was like more than at our goddamn peak back in March and April when everyone was freaking the fuck out? Dudes can't sexually assault each other. Wow.
Oh, no.
Not a very woke point of view. Ask Tucker Carlson. I like Tucker. I think he's a very level-headed, sane journalist. Wait for the Notre Dame super spread. Did you hear that? That was craziness. Did anybody hear that? Wow. There was just a giant crash in the other room. I don't know what is happening, but should we investigate? It's just the kids rustling around. This is actually terrifying. Let's crank up the mic to level 10. Sensitive stuff. And let's go see for ourselves. Let's see if we can get the mobile camera going. Oh my Lord. Cranking it up. Let's see if I can connect my iPhone and what fucking fell. Okay, is it on the screen? I can't see the chat. I don't on this. I don't think. Is this? This should be on the screen now. We're going. Everything's fine. Everything's just great. Don't worry about it. Nothing's wrong or weird. So I'd like to just everybody forget you saw anything. We'll edit this out. Definitely nothing embarrassing for me. Definitely nothing that we need to talk about or spread around or tell anybody like, oh, you should have seen it live. Again, we'll edit all this out. Please keep quiet about it. Please keep it cool between just us friends and stuff. Don't be weird. Don't make it weird. And I'd rather, you know, just not... really not deal with it. Soprano style ending. You guys making fun of our mic hiss? I'll have you know, that's some of the nicest hiss you've ever heard in your dick. And you keep it tidy. It was hissing because I cranked it way up. I turned the mic way up so you could hear me in the other room. Like if I got back here, you hear how loud this is now? It's not a hiss, it's room noise. It's air moving across the microphone. Like if I wanted to do some ASMR. So instead I turn it down. You don't get hiss, and I don't have to fucking, you know. I don't need to come. Look what you've done to my voice. You hear this? I told you I think I have COVID. My voice is cracking. My throat is fucked. You got me going. I hope you're happy with this shit. You know, First, I get treated the way I haven't even gotten to how I got treated at Costco. They have a take a number system. I just got totally skipped over by two ethnic families. You know why? Because I'm white. And you know what? This kid's never had glasses. He doesn't know what he's missing. I need an updated prescription. Did we finish with the eye doctor? What do you think I'm on right now? You old dipshit. Aren't you like, whoa, a minute ago you were happy that he kept you on track? Yeah, well, things change, Mox. Anyway, I sat there. Two families he helped, you know, Mexicans. Take a number, no way. Yeah, there is a take a number. You're out of your mind. Mine has a take a number. Get fucking bent. Where do you live? Scrum dog military school? There's a take a number. And they skipped over my number. And the guy told me he'd be right with me, and then he proceeded to help two other fucking people, and then I just walked out. So you know what? Now I'm just sucking down the sample boxes of contacts that she gave me. That's right. The Alcon Precision Ones. You want to shove something in your eye? Alcon and their Precision One collection of contact lenses. You'll love the way your eyes blink. You'll love the way your brain thinks. You'll love the way your heart sinks when you're wearing Alcon. You put on Precision Ones, you step outside of your foyer. Don't have a foyer, I say nay. You will, and you'll be happier when you get one. Slip in an Alcon. Right now, Alcon is offering $70 off per box of their new Precision One line of dailies. That's right. One box, 90 contacts, $67. That's $70 off the original price. You step up to a four-pack, I swear to God, they're going to give you $240 off of a four-pack. How can they do it? They're the only manufacturer direct-to-consumer contact producer in the United States. That's Alcon and their Precision One line of dailies. Stay moist, stay high, stay tight. Alcon, wear them through the night. Nobody likes onions. We'll be right back. What if that was a real ad that I did? Guys, thanks for kicking it old school with a really high man screaming about his treatment at Costco. Where should I buy glasses now that Costco's out of the picture? Where should I go? 1-800-contacts.org. lenses.com. Where do you get glasses? I know they got all those. There's Kirkland brand contacts now. Yeah, but we've already decided they're not getting my business. I don't like the way they treated me, and I may go in and I may go Lens Crafters. Is this a real place humans are still going? I thought this was like that smoked summer sausage store in the mall. It's just something your grandfather talked about. When I was a boy, I got all my lenses and lens crappers. That was not a Freudian. I did not mean to say that. Lens Crafters, eh? Let's have a look at their offerings and see if there's any specials in my area. 40% off lenses, 20% off contacts. Here's the thing, and you've all seen the exposés on how there's like six total companies in the world that make lenses, and really like two make like 99% of the lens frames and lenses, eyeglass frames and lenses. And I don't want, it's just like the mattress industry. It's like, I'm not interested in anything you can take 40% off of and still be good. You know, these places do this all the time, all year round. I dare you to go to your mattress store right now and see if they're not having a sale. They do it so often, they have to hunt for holidays to fucking cram. Oh, is Lens Crafters having a Veterans Day eyeglass sale? Cool. Oh, the mattress store is really cutting back prices on all Sealy Posturepedic models for Flag Day, are they? Grow up. I admire a company like Casper. NobodyLikesOnions.com/Casper. Save $75 off your bed right now. Maybe 100. I think it's 100 now. You'll save. Tell them Patrick sent you. NobodyLikesOnions.com/Casper. But, you know, they'll have, like, a price for a mattress. It doesn't really fucking change. And they build in a little bit of marketing cost, like giving you $100 off and throwing me a little cheddar as a kickback. And also, you know, they don't fuck around with this crazy sale life. Every mattress half off. Go fuck yourself. What are you talking about? It's one thing to have, like, a clearance bin. Store model, floor model. 1,900 couples have laid down and fucked on this. As I say this, the lens in my eye is becoming very, very crusted. I don't know. I feel like it might be falling out. So look what they got. I don't see. They got 40% off. Usually they'll do a buy one, get one, but I have a horrible prescription. You know, I'm blind. So what they do is this is for like a base model. Frame and lenses starting at 99, right? So you go here. Let's pull it up. Frames and lenses starting at 99. Great value package. Complete pair, frame and lenses. Starting at 99. All right, so let's do this. Armani Exchange. Okay, so I can get the great brands in here, you know. Good stuff. Post Malone glasses. Just what I'm into. All the stuff, right? So I go in here. I find one I like. Two colors for $117. So I click on this. What's your prescription? Hold on. We'll get to it. Blind as a goddamn bat. That's what it is. Add lenses. Okay. Classic. Here's where they get you. Now an $80 upgrade for advanced, high quality, impact resistant lens. Scratch. For $99, you get the frames. And classic lens, perfect for every day. But if you want our most popular choice for almost double the goddamn price, choke up. Get it. Complete pair. Our advanced, high-quality, impact-resistant. So let's go classic. Let's try to stay cheap. Classic lens and standard treatment. UV, ray, 100% block, scratch-resistant. Blue light filter. Complete. So standard treatment is classic lens. That's free. Oh no, you have to pick. Hold on, let me go back here. I'm dumb. Classic. So you get a blue light filter, an anti-reflective. I bet he'll get Coke bottle lenses. I do. I wear. That's the problem. My prescription's really bad. My glasses are thick. So you have to pay a lot of extra money to get those squashed down to like thin, you know, medium, decent glasses. It's very costly. Hold on. So you can get blue light filter. You can get scratch resistant and anti-reflective. You can get blue light filter with anti-reflective. Blue light filter protect your eyes from blue light emitted from digital screens. Who are these fucking people? You know, everybody's mom worked inside an office for the local hardware store under blinking fluorescent light bulbs. For 30 goddamn years before they retired. Why does everybody need a blue light filter to look at a fucking computer screen all day? It's like the easiest job ever. It doesn't make sense. Oh no, now people are messaging me happy birthday from Australia. It must be hitting over there. This is what's happening now. Thank you for the birthday wishes. Thank you for the birthday presents. Cash only, please, or Amazon gift cards. Don't send me stuff I'm not going to use, like magnets and door handle covers for my Tesla that I don't own. The point is, it's double the cost by the time you get it. And okay, let's say I get anti-reflective treatment. Cool. Once I put those in my bag, they'll want me to pay. Blue light filters more for night, I think, to help you, your body gets sleepy. It said to protect you from computer light. Fuck are you talking about? Oh, now they're liars over at lenscrafters.org. Let's go to everybody's favorite, Warbly Porker. Now, this is the new... Now, I did one of these in New York. So you could order like 5 pairs of glasses. And they send them to you like frames with clear lenses. Try 5 frames at home for free. Oh, they're still doing this? Maybe I'll try this. Maybe I'll give Warbly Porker another shot. Should we pick out my frames? You guys tell me what you think would look good on me. Because it won't be the same as like this guy, you know. I don't think I'm going to wear anything called the Carlton or the Bagley. What are they naming these after, Ed Bagley Jr.? I have blue light glasses, not prescription, but they do help. It's for people that look at PC screens. It's why night shift exists. They're all scammers. You guys are on to something. I think all these are too trendy of shapes for me. I can't wear stuff like this. This is crazy. Round, like almost Harry Potterish, you know, horn rims. Get the fuck out of here. What do you guys think about the Tatum and the Winston? Are these... Maybe you should get invisible braces too. Maybe why I oughta. I'm very upset about the election. You guys don't want to upset me right now while I'm trying to spend money, make money, get money, build pools. No one is into the way the election's being stolen from us, and you guys all think it's fucking fun and games, but it ain't. It's all TikTok, don't stop, body rock, beat the clock. The Langhorne, the Percy, none of these feel like the right shape for my head. The Landon, this feels like something Chip Chris would wear and think was hip. Chelsea, find me a man who's interested in this. Glasses that look like they're cut out of marble. And I'll find you a man who's not cool. Look at this. Hughes the Butler. I can't with this stuff. Mullins. Hayden. The Durand. I actually don't mind the Durand. I think that could be a smart look. What if you got this in blue and clear where you can see the wire straight through it? Does that make me like dope and fresh? What do you guys think? If you can like see through the clear, it's like those phones you could get in the 90s where you could see all the speaker and the fucking circuit boards and the wiring. And you were like, I didn't know it took that much stuff to make a phone. But apparently it did. And apparently it did. These are more the shape I think I would go with, though. I'll tell you that. The Durand, the Mullins. I think black's too bold. pink is crazy. Are these unisex? What is their deal? Does anybody know? Hayden? These aren't bad. I don't know if I would go with that gray. Feels a little sharp to me. Brady? Not bad. I'm sorry that this just turned into me shopping. They aren't unisex. They're trans. My fucking bad. Can we talk about the election a little bit? I don't know what's going on. I'll tell you this. If you ever wanted proof that the media and like the tech social media companies are controlling everything, holy shit, look at this election. We are really out of our gourds. And I'll tell you what I do know. 100%. I know two things. Well, not 100. Nobody knows anything 100%. Number one, 90% Joe Biden will be the next president of the United States. Number two, everyone is out of their goddamn minds. I don't think any states have certified their election results. You know, CNN and all these news channels started calling the election. It doesn't mean anything. They are fucking suing everyone. And by the way, finding stuff. And I don't think it matters, but they are finding stuff. It is sus. And it's weird to have half the country delusional to think that there's going to be some sort of a conspiracy that goes deep enough to make a difference. I have no doubt dead people voted. I have no doubt there's some sort of voter interference and voter fraud here and there. It happens all the time. From what I understand, they sent out like 1.5 million stimulus checks this past summer to dead people that got cashed. So it's crazy. Can't know how your pupil sits in frames. That's why they send out a bunch. Yeah, I mean, they have apps that can do it now. It's pretty good. The virtual reality kind of shit, right? I don't know. But I'll tell you this. It's fucking weird. It's fucking weird. And, of course, there'll be some weird shit. Shenanigans. Ne'er-do-wells. But I don't think it'll be enough to make a difference in enough states to matter. However, I would like to know if there's something going on with the election. Was there any tampering of any kind of anything? I'd like to know. Wouldn't you? It's weird to me that half the country is like, more than half the country is like, let's move on. It's like, I don't know. If something's going on. The AP has only been calling the election since the 1800s. Did the AP call it? But yeah, it's super weird. Look, it's not weird. Look, I'm not saying that these places aren't allowed to call it. What's weird is to be upset that Donald Trump is going to, like, follow through with every legal action available to him. Like, of course he is. So, like, there is, like, a constitutional process for this, correct? Like, and he's allowed to do this. This is what the thing is, like, almost everybody who has problems with Trump that are, like, actual problems with, like, policy things or like, legal things, like him, like, not releasing his taxes or him putting kids in cages at borders or him not accepting the election and investigating. It's like, these are all things that are like laws. You know, a lot of these states are so close it triggers automatic recounts. Let's not act like Hillary Clinton didn't have recounts done. Let's not act like Al Gore didn't stall up. I think Al Gore took weeks. I don't know. Look up how long Al Gore took. People aren't upset about recounts. It's that he's saying there was definitely large-scale fraud. I mean, the dude says crazy shit all the time. I'm not interested in what he says. I'm not interested in how he makes people feel. I'm interested in laws and were they broken or not. Like, that's all I care about. And no, that's not why people are upset. People are going, he won't accept it. He won't just back down. It's fucking weird. The side that won are acting like babies. Insane babies. I, for one, am, Jake Lloyd posted some shit. I, for one, am glad our racist, rapist, fascist denier-in-chief has been removed. And it's just like, I don't know if you can actually call somebody a rapist unless you know for a fact they raped or they've been convicted of rape. I think those are the two qualifying criteria for rape. And I know it's fun to grab him by the pussy and all that. Like, I get it. But at the end of the day, like, I'm not talking about making fun of him for stuff. I'm talking about, like, having solid, concrete reasons. Four Seasons Total Landscaping. Yeah, that's fucking hilarious. It is. That is fucking funny. It's all a lie. Oh, God. It's so good. I am enjoying it. I am going to enjoy sitting back and watching the world burn. As long as the stock market stays up, I don't really have an opinion or care. I do think you've all been duped. I do think if you think you're a Biden guy, I'll tell you this. If you think you're a Biden person, you are out of your mind. You're not. You don't like Biden. You hate Trump. And I hope it wasn't a mistake. I'm telling you, Biden looks like Papa at the last Thanksgiving you ever saw him at. Oh, thanks for the sub. Really cool stuff. But it's the last time you might see Biden. You know, he will be out very soon. And I worry about Kamala Harris. These people are crooked as fuck. I think I tweeted this in 2016. It's not that I don't think Donald Trump is corrupt and a fucking nightmare, because I do. It's that you think the other ones aren't. It's that you think these guys are good people. They are fucking pulling the wool over your eyes. Nobody voted for Biden, remember? What? I don't get how people voted for either one. Trump is Republican, so he's evil. Right. But that's the way it works. And I think that society is crumbling because of these millennials, I'm telling you. A lot of these people who are 30 years old and younger, this is the first time they voted for somebody who didn't win in 2016. And they couldn't handle it. And that's why all the anti-Trump shit started. Like, that's where it all got hardcore, you know. And it's weird because, and again, I'm not saying like Trump is an embarrassment and he is sometimes a complete dummy. But he hasn't really done anything crazy. So like, calm down. You're still allowed to get your abortion, whores. You're still allowed to get an abortion. Who cares? You're still allowed to get married, gays. No one's coming after that stuff. No, Trump just never seemed right for the office. Look at how he's acting now. What? You're out of your mind. Look, I think, don't get me wrong. I think if it all turns out to be legitimate and everything's fine, he should step down. I don't think he will. I think he's a psycho, but he probably will because there's not really much choice. But if there is something going on, if there is something fucking seedy going on with the voting, I'd like to know. I think it's weird that anyone would not like to know. So, like, Who cares? Let's have the lawsuits. Let's go through the courts. There's going to need to be significant evidence of major shit on the scale of tens of thousands of votes. He's going to announce his 2024 campaign. Yeah, probably. He'll probably faction off a bunch of people, but maybe that's what we need. Break the two-party system. Let's get a serious third party going. And not when I say serious, I don't mean maybe something worth considering, but like one that's like actually has, here's all you need, like 25% to 30% of the people on board. Like that's all you really need. And I think if he could get his foot in the door to do it, then of course the libertarians could have a seat at the table. God, you know, what if we had a fucking debate, a presidential debate or series of them with 4 to 5 candidates? I'm sorry. These are the best people we could come up with in our country. You're all out of your goddamn mind. If cheating is happening and Trump fixes it, won't make him a good president. Yeah, I don't know. Whatever. Well, I would ask you what makes him a bad president. I'm honestly curious. I'm just asking. Like, I don't have, like, I don't know. Like, my life is definitely better than it was 4 years ago. So I don't know. I've done well on investments. The economy's good. I make decent money. I don't know. Obamacare is shit. So he wants to abolish Obamacare, I guess. I don't know if that I give a fuck. It's insanely expensive. No, I'm saying that when people will say to... I'm saying then people will have to say he's a good president. Trump has been golfing more than any other president, making our government pay his resort huge amounts just to protect him. Yeah, he's fucking brilliant. I'm sorry. Just because he, like, first of all, if he's going on a trip to here or to there or whatever, like, of course he's going to stay at his own resort. They know how he likes his pudding. You know, like, yeah, of course he's going to stay at the place that has, like, the suite that's decked out for him, that has all his favorite things, including a 2004 scroll wheel iPod with all his favorite songs. But I would argue, you know, Biden, I'm telling you, Biden, it's his last pass, dude. This guy won't make it 4 years. Ajit Pai. Great. But also, it has to make you, wake up and realize how much shit is censored and stuff. Like, you're all fucking, like, sheep. You're all sheeple, man. You don't know. You don't know fucking anything. Biden said he only plans to be a one-term president. I'm sure. Good luck making it. I'm telling you, if you've got a death pool, you should put it. NASA had a good leader for once. Held a message for hostility. What? I don't like that kind of stuff. Yeah, I don't know, man. I'm just telling you this. You don't want to like Trump? Fine. You don't want to agree with Trump on things. Is he rude? Is he crass? Is he mean? Does he not give a fuck? I mean, sure. Sure. But you know who, like, also is kind of like that is, like, Elon Musk. I don't know. Like, I want, and I'm not saying Trump is this guy. I'm not saying it is. But I do like the idea of having a private businessman run shit and not give a fuck. Like, yeah, he doesn't give a fuck about what you feel or how you feel the country is doing at this. He doesn't care if the media is spinning up a narrative that police are hunting down unarmed black kids and shooting him in the back of the head for points in some secret game. Like, it just goes by data. It just goes by fact. It doesn't hide part of the story. He doesn't give a fuck about anything. He only cares for himself. Okay. This is Ken Solomon, who was clearly drank the left Kool-Aid hard. Like, this guy's out of his mind. Trust isn't all liked either, though. Trust Musk. That's what I'm saying. Yeah, people don't like Elon Musk because he's not a fucking platitudes guy. You go watch any of these recent Biden speeches, I'm telling you, there's nothing there. This dude has nothing. It's all like, I'm going to be president for everybody. I thought about unity and we're going to come together and we need to not divide. And it's just like, there's nothing there. Dude, I'll talk for 17 minutes, about that shit. And it's like, you said nothing, bro. I don't see what's wrong with Trump. Well, he's an ass. Like, he is a fucking buffoon. I don't think he's very bright individually. I think he has a lot of business instinct and comes in. I don't think he presents ideas well. I think he uses inflammatory language. Trump has nothing there either. He complained about a lot of places he visited for his rallies. Yeah. He doesn't speak smart. He doesn't speak intelligently and says a lot of like very inflammatory stuff. But this is your argument, like, Ken, like, so do you understand? Hold on. There are no more KKK. It just doesn't exist anymore. Wake up, sheeple. Yeah. Yeah, I'm not saying there's none. I'm saying that it's not a problem. It's not rampant. There's no big issue that it needs to be like top story on the news every night that like racism has engulfed our country. Our nation is at war. It's like nobody's not getting along except for the news firing everybody up. Trump has nothing there either. He complained about a lot of places he visited for rallies. I like Biden, but I'll give it to Trump. He's done some good for Israel. Right. So when it comes to anything policy-wise, people don't really have an... They go like, he shit on places he visit. He said grab girls by the pussies. People really conflate saying something with doing something, you know? So, like... When you ask people who say Donald Trump is a rapist, and look, I'm not sticking up for Trump. I'm sticking up for fairness because there's a lot of stuff to make fun of Trump about. Don't get me wrong. He's a fucking asshat. I'm on board with the Trump trolling, Trump teasing, but you have to be fair with it or everything you say goes out the goddamn window. You have to be fair with that shit. So when people go like, Trump's a rapist, and it's like, okay, like, who did he rape? And then there's like, well, there was accusations and da-da-da-da-da. These women came out and said that. It's like, okay. I don't know, man. Unless he's proven or convicted of it, I don't know. We have, again, sorry, we do have a thing in this country that you're innocent until you're proven guilty. I'm sorry. I don't know what everyone's talking about. It's very cut and dry. So as far as I know, our current sitting president hasn't been convicted of rape. Correct me if I'm wrong. If we do have a president right now walking around who is convicted of rape, I'm very concerned. But I'm not sure. You tell me. Well, he's a fascist. And it's like, I don't think he's a Nazi. I don't think people know what these words mean. They just throw things out. He's been trying to use the presidency to avoid and throw out one of those cases. He's had some bad policies, but Israel did some good. Course for Clorkers. OJ is innocent. I actually do believe that OJ took the fall for his son. Whoa, that's a good... I haven't heard that conspiracy. I'd be very interested in sitting down and talking to you and your mother over some pecan sandies or perhaps some Pepperidge Farm Milano cookies. You're right. He's innocent until proven guilty, but he's been subpoenaed for his DNA to confirm evidence. Like, great. Great. Like, do you understand that, like, everything everyone that is upset about is, like, legal? It's like, well, you put kids in the border and separated from them, and they put them in the... It's like, that was a law Obama set up and built the detention centers for. So he followed a law. He wants to send illegal immigrants in our country back home. It's like, that's the law. I don't know what's wrong with everyone. Yeah, but everyone who wants to come in should just come in. Like, what are you all talking about? That's never been the way it is. It's never going to be the way it is, lest there be chaos. The detention centers were 3 to 4 present. No, these specific ones were built by Obama. And these specific acts were signed into law by Obama for these centers. He drove his car all the way to Texas and stored it in a locker. OJ took the Bronco so he'd have time to leave California. And then he traded that car into cars for kids, and that's how OJ got away with it.
Oh, no.
Look, all I'm saying is everyone's fucking problems. It's like, I bet you're better than you were 4 years ago. I'm pretty sure. I don't know why you're not. If you're not, you're not doing things right. And I'm sorry. Everything the fucking Democrats get their hands on costs $1 million more and doesn't work 1 million times less. Like, it just, like, it doesn't, we're not good at it. Privatize all of it. Do you know what's so fucked about this election, you fucking cucks? I'm glad we have you to tell us like it is. Here's some bits. Thank you. It's about time people realized my genius. It's easy to sit there and fucking throw around. Here's the thing. It's like, most of us do get along and agree on everything. We all just want what's best for everyone. Some people want what's best for them. And that's where we all fucking clash. Because when you get selfish, it makes me selfish. Well, if you think that, I think this. And now we just keep getting farther and farther from each other. Would everybody shut the fuck up and just get along? They want us fighting, idiots. They want you thinking Trump is a fucking Nazi, awful dude. When the fact is, he's just kind of a middle-of-the-road dolt of a president, akin to George W. Bush. He's about that. Like, he really is. You're all fucking nuts and overreacting, and you don't even understand it. Now, on the other side, he's not some fucking savior Jesus. He's kind of a dumb businessman who's pretty much a coin flip away from success with everything he does. You know, some things he fucking does, they work out great. Some things he doesn't, they don't work out. Why did The Apprentice work out? Because he's kind of a fucking dummy, and it's funny to watch the gold man putz around and point his finger and be mean to people. Oh, the guy who brought people into a room, pointed out their flaws, and fired them in front of millions is kind of a ruthless ruler. Yeah, he doesn't give a fuck whether you think it looks bad to be in the Paris Climate Accord. The fact is, it's a non-binding resolution jerk-off thing that doesn't do shit to move the needle. And usually, that kind of shit usually ends up costing America way more than we get out of the fucking joint venture that is whatever the fuck it is that ends up not moving the needle at all. The fact is, we're doing very well when it comes to clean energy. We'll be better soon, as soon as Biden gets rid of all the coal and fracking. Akin to George Costanza. Yeah. Maybe we need more empathy as a president. I agree. A president should have more empathy than Trump. I'm not saying there's not a problem with fucking Trump. There's plenty of problems with Trump, but let's focus on those real problems and not the shit. He's a racist Nazi. It's like Kim Kardashian's on that fucking Letterman interview saying that he like did more for black people as a president than Obama did. Like, especially for, like, prisoners, of non-violent offenders in prison, and getting them out and changing laws. Signing legislation, actual work. Is Kim Kardashian a fucking idiot? Are we all, do we all hate her now? What's happening? Stop believing all the pop-ups on Facebook. Follow your fucking heart, sheeple. Patrick, you're not from the NYC area, but what are your thoughts on Bloomberg? I'd have loved to see him as president, to be honest. I don't know. I don't know, man. I would love to see like an Elon Musk or even a like Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Just a no-nonsense motherfucker with good intentions who thinks outside the fucking box. You think Kamala Harris, like this bitch, he's a fucking wind-blowing, lane-switching freak. The allegation she fucked her way to the top. Who knows? I don't know. She was seeing a mayor when he was married. They say it was on the up and up. Still sus. You don't think, talk to a black person and ask them what the Democrats have done for them. You're out of your mind. They need to keep you down. They need programs. They want all these free programs, free stuff, free stuff, free stuff. They're treating you like they're throwing out watermelon and fried chicken coupons. They want you suckling at the Aunt Jemima tit. Peter Booty Chork. Yeah, am I right, guys? Ladybugs. Let's stay away from the celebrities. I'm telling you, man. They want you all fighting. They want you all poor and dumb, suckling at their tit, needing their welfare programs, needing their fucking food stamps, needing their stimulus package. They're holding you hostage. They're poisoning your brain. Both sides. Wake the fuck up about it. Follow Trump 2024. No, I don't know. I don't know the answer. Here's how you know it's crooked, and here's how you know it's all fucking rigged. The Cubans all voted for Biden. That is not true. That is not true. You're talking about like guys who've come over from a fucking, yeah, I'm sure the Cubans were really down for Biden and his socialist ideas. Worked out great for Cuba. Is it true they're making the frogs gay? Yeah, Alex Jones said they're putting something in the water, and I don't have proof, but it's coming in later today. UPS is on the way over. They're putting gay frogs in our water. Wake up, sheeple. Look, we've had a lot of fun here today spouting conspiracy theories and stuff, but I hope it does make you think, and I would say this, definitely watch both sides of the fucking news and see how they're playing you. And if you want proof, like just basic, simple proof that they don't want you to know what's going on, it's insane that we're a week out. We don't know what the accurate vote count is. It's insane that there's not a process that works for accounting for votes, super secure, identifiable, it's like you can apply for a mortgage online and you have to fill out a quiz to prove your identity. What streets have you lived on? What cars have you owned? You know, this pop quiz, do you have to like navigate this maze of like 10 questions, you know, exactly right about your life and history. You know, combine that with things like Apple ID, scans of driver's license that now have data embedded on the back through codes, through barcodes. It's like if they wanted to, they could 100% make a system where you could vote accurately and securely online, have a public record of it, see that your vote was counted and part of the total, you know, in a blockchain style type system, open, not where people could see other people's votes, but where you could see your vote and that it was part of the tally, that it was being counted and registered in the total, and anyone could count up the votes. This ledger, this system could be implemented. Anyone could do it from around the world, military, absentee, whatever, 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 using two-factor, three-factor, pre-verification, whatever the fuck. If they wanted to do it, they could. It's not important. It's not important. Do you think, like, do you understand that any business that's incentivized to get the numbers right, they get them right and they get them fast? You know, Facebook, all these big, you think if Amazon was charged with building an election system for the country, it wouldn't be done in a year and it wouldn't be fucking awesome and instant? If Facebook was in charge of it, if Elon Musk was in charge of it, of course it would. They don't care. Why does the DMV suck? They don't care. Where else you gonna go? You gonna go somewhere else to vote? No. Get back in line, idiot. Where are you gonna go get your license? Doesn't fucking matter. This is the only place, stupid. They don't care. If they cared, you'd have your results. If they cared, it would be definitive. It's not. So there's going to be lawsuits, and it's going to go to court. Strap in. Stop bitching about it. It's part of the law. It's baked into our Constitution. There's a process. It'll all get sorted out. Everybody will go home, or if they won't, they'll get kicked. I saw this. Somebody posted this the other day. I hope they go in, shoot him in the face, and drag his body out the front steps. It's like, that's cool. I don't want to be a part of whatever psycho, intolerant, violent shit the left is part of right now. I don't like it. I'm a liberal. I'm not a left. And you guys have gone insane, and I'm not on board with it, and I'm terrified of it. And the fact that you don't see that these motherfuckers, whether it's Biden or Harris, are chameleons who will say anything to get your fucking vote. Don't, and I'm not one of these crime bill guys. Look at the crime bill. It's like, that doesn't even fucking matter to me. What I'm telling you is that they don't care. Like, from gay marriage, gays in the military, this party will just keep flip-flopping and switching to tell you anything that's popular right now. You heard about this call that leaked out where they were like, we got to stop saying socialist and we got to drop the Black Lives Matter stuff. It's losing us votes. Yeah, it's a marketing team, man. Okay, boomer. Thank you very much, man. That hurts. I need a new Miss Cleo to decide the elections. I'm just saying, if it was important, man, you'd push a button, you'd vote, it'd be over. We'd have real-time results. The fact that you think Trump is... I don't think Trump is better, but no one is sticking up for this dude. No one is talking about it. I'm not going to be one of the people who pile on for dumb shit. because it crosses a line from not just teasing a guy you don't like to where you're at. These even news media outlets, you got me. these motherfuckers are fucking trolling me. I don't like that shit. Really rude, really rude stuff. Please don't do that to me. But people do think that shit. And it's like, just be honest. Just be real. Let it play out. We'll all find out what's real, and then it'll be great. If he doesn't leave, it's going to be a goddamn show, and I can't wait. Riots in the streets, freaks in the sheets. I don't think Biden is good, but for things like the pandemic, I voted for the guy I prefer to point to and ask for help. Yeah, I get it. I'm not saying you don't have a choice. By all means, vote. Do it for the right reasons. You sound like you did it for the right reasons. That's fine. And then the U.S. government forgets to pay for their AWS bill, right? Then what, stupid? Oh, then we all lose our blockchain votes. I don't know, man. I don't have all the answers, jerks. What do you think? What do you think? I'm just one of these loose rootin' tootin' cowboys shooting. I'm not going to move out into the fucking wilderness and get a tent and live off the grid with just solar powered and a wood stove. I won't be that man. But I'll tell you the other thing. I can't ever become the kind of fucking pathetic sheep I'm watching you all be. You fucking lie chuggers. Let's all be cool. Let's all be good to each other. Satellite servers for the votes, blockchain and the stars, Starlink. Yeah, whatever it is, man. I know it would work better. That's all I'm fucking saying. I just know it would work better than whatever the fuck we're doing now. If they wanted to have it, you know, they had all pandemic long, what with the Snowflake IPO and stuff. Come on. Starlink's is a hoax. You'll think that when that's what's used to build the dome over us. Like, you know what I mean? Like Biodome or Encino Man. Starlink, they link together, 3D print some sort of polymer that seals us in between Starlink nodes. What's he going to have, like 20,000 of those fucking satellites zipping around the world? I don't know. I would say this, man. You don't have a lot of time on this earth, I heard. So you running around acting like a goddamn nut trying to change it all makes you look like a fucking savage. You seem weird, bro. And I know you're all touched in the head, and I know especially during the pandemic, biggest lie of 2020, Neuralink the votes to the Starship. Yeah. Put me on that boat. First one. I'll go. Let's get out of here and have a nice day. I hope you caught the show earlier. I hope you enjoyed that. The Apple reveal. We talked a lot about it. Love Pauly Shore. What's not to love? He started everything right down there on the old Sunset Strip with his mom, Ditzy, and his dad, Baron. Baron Shore. NobodyLikesOnions.com/overdose. We've got a PM and the AM coming out. Tons of election coverage. I think about 9 hours, which will be mostly overdose only. You're going to want to get out on that. Here the night that we thought Trump was going to win in a landslide. We were all, it was deja vu from 2016. All over again. We just sat there watching the map turn red, watching the news anchors fucking freaking out a little bit. It got real. Thank God they manufactured the votes, found the absentee ballots, and made short work of the hanging chads. You know, thank fucking God. And now we can all look forward to our leader, Zombie Sadman, and the Crooketeers. Only protective case around my paper I want is a fortune cookie. Can't hack those. What if we did have to bake our votes into cake and we couldn't name a president until everybody had their fucking cake? Would you get on with your lives, everybody? Please. Move on. Nothing is important. Everything doesn't matter. You'll be fine. Trump or not, you'll be fine. Stop hanging your hat on the government and their fucking tits. You know, get the fuck over it. I've had enough of it. I've had enough of you. I've had enough. Let's all get out. Tomorrow's my birthday. If you haven't gotten me anything, it's, you know, it's high time and it's the last moments. And I'm not going to ask again. This has been Patrick Melton. This has been Nobody Likes Onions. Join the overdose. Join the scrim. Get us some scrim. And get on the scram. You're not going to troll me anymore. I'm woke. Empty space.